seconds. What's up, EK? Ah! 15 seconds. Let's go. Summer Game Pass. GG, Geoff and the team. I can't wait. Oh my gosh. Your discretion is advised. It's Geoff!
I told you we'd start right on time. Hello everyone around the world and welcome to Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live presented by Prime Gaming. I'm Geoff Keighley and buckle up because we've got a big show for you filled with new game announcements, world premieres,
how's the volume?
The games you play every day. Some surprises and special guests, including Jeff Goldblum, Giancarlo Esposito, and performances by Weezer, Japanese Breakfast, and the Sonic the Hedgehog Symphony Orchestra. Yes, that's really a thing. Now, like a great video game, there may be some twists along the way
today. Thank you!
And just wait until you see what we have planned for the end game. That is all I'm allowed to tell you right now. This is just the start of a big Summer Game Fest weekend of news and updates for fans, including live-streamed events from publishers like Xbox and Bethesda, Square Enix, Ubisoft, and more. You can head right now to summergamefest.com to track all the events.
He's so pumped.
There is a lot of great stuff coming
your way.
Let's
go!
But today, we kick things off with a big 90-minute cross-industry showcase meant to put platforms and rivalries aside. We will have updates and news for you, no matter if you play on Nintendo Switch, PC, PlayStation, or Xbox. The biggest games in the world will be here, and some of the smallest ones, too, made by emerging voices and developers from around the world who represent what's next. Thank you so much for tuning in and kicking off Video Game Summer. Well, let's begin with
a brand new
game announcement. You're about to see the world premiere of the next great adventure.
World premiere!
From Gearbox and 2K.
Take a shot! World premiere. Gearbox, okay. Dragons?
Fate.
This it already looks cool.
It rises. From the grave. It stalks the ocean floor. You cannot hide from fate. But you can make your own.
Ooh, that looks awesome! It has the style. What? Is it a show? No, it's a game. It's me! It's me! What? Wonderland? Oh my gosh. Is it a D&D game? Borderlands D&D? Did you say
Tiny Tina's Wonderlands is official, and joining us now is Tiny Tina herself, Ashley Wirsch. Hey, Ash, how you
What's
doing?
What's up, baby? How you doing?
Great to have you here. So
she's also
the
on the Apple Show.
What is Wonderlands? What
Mystic
can you tell
Quest?
Us about it?
Great question. Yeah. It's a high fantasy take on a looter shooter, as you saw. And,
I love her.
If you're a fan of Borderlands, you'll probably recognize some fantasy elements inspired by Assault on Dragon Keep, which was the Borderlands 2 DLC that was beloved by the devs, and so this kind of inspired Wonderlands.
Now, I think the elephant in the room is this a Borderlands game? Is it not? How does it relate?
So it actually isn't. It's its own standalone game. And people that love Borderlands are gonna find lots of elements to love about Wonderlands, but it's its own thing.
She's
Tiny
awesome. Yeah. If you haven't
now,
seen
so it's
Mystic Quest,
there's spell casting. You can customize your character this time, which is super exciting.
Oh my gosh!
And yeah, so if you love Borderlands, you're gonna find stuff to love in this. And if you've never played a Borderlands game, this is a great place to start.
Okay, well, Tiny Tina gets her own game, which is fantastic. Yes. What is her role? Why does she get her own game?
So she is your bunker master. She's kind of guiding the narrative and changing it on a dime if she wants. And she's just taking your cast of characters, which is an amazing cast, through this wacky world, and she's taking you on an adventure to defeat the Dragon Lord.
This is gonna be amazing. Mythic Quest, that's what it is.
And okay. I wonder who plays the Dragon Lord, because you've got quite the voice cast, including you in this, which is awesome. So feels like such a big experience. So this was a bit of a tease, announcing it's out there. When will we find out more about this game?
Hopefully this summer, and you can find out a lot more at playwonderlands.com if you'd like.
Okay.
But yeah, just stay tuned for updates.
All right, coming early 2022, so look forward to next year. Ash, thank you so much for joining us in person.
Thanks for having me.
I really appreciate it, and we'll see more later this summer on that game. All right, well, now it is time for another brand new game announcement.
Yeah,
this one,
I had no idea that would come out.
Classic 90s franchise is coming back to life as a grid-based tactical strategy title for Steam on PC. This is an insanely fun trailer. I hope you'll enjoy it.
Let me know if it's too quiet. The game? Oh, yes! It's supposed to be like a 90s. Is this Metal Slug? It looks so good! I've never seen this, though. Now I have to. Oh, God. Oh, gosh. Final Fantasy Tactics? Kind of, yeah. I like the art style. Right. We're two games in. Metal Slug Tactics. So yeah, you're right. It's like a tactic game.
Okay, we have another big announcement for you from a surprise guest, but it's well past 3 a.m. their time. So don't worry, we chatted earlier, and I'm very excited to share this with you right now. Hello, mystery guest.
Hello. Hi.
Mr. Kojima, it is so good to see you. Thank you for joining us from Tokyo. First of all, I just want to ask, how are you doing? How are you feeling? How are things right now over there
Hello?
In Japan?
Tokyo ではですね、また非常事態宣言っていうのが出てて、
ちょっとコロナの、
患者数が増えつつあると。で、ワクチンをそろそろ打ち出そうとしてる、そういう感じですね。
Well, we certainly hope that you're going to get your vaccine soon. Let me ask you, as a creator, how has this past year impacted you?
まあ、今までのものづくりっていうのはまあ今自分がいる世界を見てで地続きで5年後10年後20年後どうなるかっていうのを考えながらそこにエンターテインメントを加えていってまあ作ってたのが結構その10年後20年後に当たってたりっていうのはあったんですけど今回の DS に関してはもう発売直後になったのでちょっとかなりものの考え方が変わったというか、ものづくりのスタンスがちょっと変わったというか、いろいろ考えました。今後のものづくり、やっぱりエンターテインメントである以上、まあ楽しんでもらって、そのプレイヤーのためになるものを作りたいっていうんですけど、 こんなにも早くこう時代が追いついてくるとちょっとこうなんていうんでしょうね、フィクションじゃなくなってしまうので、でなんで今回のコロナの中で、この先をどう作るかっていうのはいろいろ考えましたね。あの他のクリエイターも多分大きく考えていると思います。あの911の時と同じような感じだと思います、ね、これからエンタメをどういうふうに切り取っていくかっていうのはやっぱり大きな課題ではありますね。
Well, I know we are all very curious about what the next era of Hideo Kojima Entertainment is going to be. I don't know how much you can say, but can you give us any sense of kind of where your mind's at right now, what you're thinking about, some of the
things? Oh my God, why am I crying?
言えないですか。今までのような、こう一歩一歩進むものじゃないんですよね。やっぱりその時もそうですけど。
Why am I crying?
このコロナでガラリとあらゆるものが変わっていく。
He called it, man. He like super called it.
そこでエンターテインメントが遅れを取ってしまうとダメなんで。
They didn't have to go so hard. God.
どうするかというその予測ですね。まあ、全くこう宇宙人が攻めてくるとか、
oh my gosh. そういうゲームであれば、okay, Kojima. I get it.
コロナ禍でも関係ないんでしょうけど、やっぱりこう、社会性の基盤を持ったエンターテインメントというのを作りたいですし、皆さんに起こりつつあることをエンターテインメントの中でちょっとこう紹介したいというのもあるので、今後世の中がどちらの方向に向かっていくかっていうのが今まで以上にすごく急激に変わっていっているので、そこを間違えないように作るというか、そこはすごく神経質になってます今。
All right, fair enough. I tried. Well, Mr. Kojima, honestly, I really do appreciate you making the time to stop by and just say hello to everyone. We miss you and we can't wait to see what you're working on next. So, thank you.
Doesn't he want to make a horror game? I think he wants to make a horror game next. Oh, I can't. That was awesome. It was so awesome to hear from someone so massive in the industry talk about the recent events and stuff, you know. That's like really cool to see and hear. What's up, South? I mean, maybe. Deathel Gear Stranding. Ew, the baby! I will say, I don't recommend playing or watching this game if you're pregnant. Just don't do it. Just wait. Don't do it. It's weird. It was not good. We've got a box, everyone. We've got a box. We've got a box. No oranges. He is in the box. We're in the box. He's in the box. We're doing the box. We just wanted to make sure that it was good to go. Wait, you have oranges. No, was it? Oh, I haven't played it. I need to play it. I really want to play Metal Gear. Whoa, director's cut. Does that mean there's going to be like 40 hours of cinematic? Sir.
There you have it. Death Stranding director's cut finally confirmed. I hope I make it into the director's cut. I'm told the full reveal is just weeks away. Stay tuned. All right, next. It's my honor to welcome to Summer Game Fest a legendary actor who dedicated a whole episode of his Disney Plus show to exploring the world of gaming and has been in games like Call of Duty Black Ops 3. And we're thrilled to have him here at Summer Game Fest. Geoff Goldblum, how are you, my friend?
Oh, my God, I can't handle this.
Thank you so much, Joffrey or Geoff or... I think it's Jeffrey. Hey, maybe it's Geoff. Hi, Geoff. Thank you so much, sincerely, for having me here. I'm thrilled to be here. Hey, I was watching your show, and I was wondering if there might be some video game world premieres, as you say. And sure enough, yeah, there is.
Yes, we do like our world premieres around here. Any chance you brought one with you today?
Well, it's funny you should say that. Yes, you could say, yes, I do. If you don't mind, I've got something here. I'm going to read it on this. There's a little bit of a teleprompter that they're putting up here. So I'm going to read something because I don't want to get it wrong. I'm very meticulous about this. So here's a dramatic reading of this game announcement. Ready? I'm going to make the game announcement right now. Hello. I'm here to welcome you to a very different world. It's going to elevate you to new heights. It's going to submerge you to new depths. Maybe even challenge you to control chaos. Actually, it's going to certainly challenge you to control chaos. It's a world so-called evolved. Take a look at the... You guessed it, world premiere.
good. Take a drink.
He ignored all the warnings.
Oh my God!
Used our power.
Are you kidding?
We played with genetics like it was a toy.
good. We're going to have to make a highlight of this. Cause...
And now, here we are.
where's Formal? I'm actually getting a dino emote made. You guys.
Different world.
Jurassic World Evolution 2. Wait, is it the Do you remember when we played the Telltale game? Is that what this is? This seems very different. I don't think this is Telltale's. 2021?
All right, this performer's new album, Jubilee, is out now, and her book, Crying in H Mart, is a New York Times bestseller. Here now to perform Glider from the upcoming open world game, Sable.
I'm having so much fun. This is awesome.
It's Japanese breakfast.
Oh my God, this performance. By the way, this is live. Looks like Greece. Hi, Cyrus. How are you? It feels like everything is moving around me. Feels like it is moving in time. Thank you. This is cool. This is such a cool way to showcase a game. With actual game footage. That is really cool. Boom, copyright strike. You got me! No! Listen, they said stream at your own discretion, you know, and you just never know. So here we are. We're risking it for the biscuit, man. Worth it.
So beautiful.
Sable.
Thank you, Sable will be released on September 23rd this year. That's some news for
oh
you.
Oh my
learn
gosh.
More about this amazing
we're going to have
game,
to
watch the
play more games,
showcase.
Fam.
That is tomorrow, where Sable was named an official selection of the Legendary Festival. Now, today is just the start of Summer Game Fest. Day of the Devs with IM 8-Bit and Double Fine will immediately follow the live show today. And there are more events coming all weekend and all month, including the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase on Sunday. It's going to be a good one. Right now, though, we're thrilled to announce the upcoming Western release of a spectacular 3D massively multiplayer online role-playing game. Welcome to the world of Lost Ark from Smilegate RPG and Amazon Games.
Amazon has been working really hard. I remember testing a bunch of stuff for them a couple years ago in their gaming department, and their devs on that team make games they actually want to make. It's really kind of cool. Sometimes they hit and sometimes they don't hit, but wait, is this the one we tested? I don't remember. No. It looks similar, but once again, the demon. Hey, hi, money. Oh my gosh. Bring destruction and waking nightmares. Ooh, wait. This looks awesome, actually. Wonder what it is. Imagine Amazon Games using non-DMCA safe music. Ah! I'm just here for all the dragons. Okay, give me all the dragons. I need them all. Whoa, big tree. Big tree. Lost Ark. It's here. Whoa. Hi, Carpenter, how are you? Also, welcome to the stream if you're just joining.
Sometimes when you play a game, there's that one thing in your inventory which turned out to be far more useful than
it's all. It's not even 11:30 yet.
That's kind of like Prime Gaming. If you're an Amazon Prime member, and most of you probably are, you get a ton of gaming goodies every month.
It's true.
This month, you can download Battlefield
Connect your account.
4 and Batman the
get
Telltale
your free
series,
sub.
Completely free for PC, and there are special in-game benefits
true.
And perks in GTA Online, Valorant, Apex Legends, and more that you can unlock. It's awesome value, and honestly, this kickoff show would not have been possible without the Prime Gaming folks believing in my vision for a new way to bring you the news this summer. So, head over to gaming.amazon.com to check out all the perks and free games, which change every month, but you get to keep
what's up, Monk?
Forever.
Or Ark, hi! I've known Ark since before streaming, actually. Black Desert? Oh, no, no. This is a... Okay, this is just like a... Oh, we're actually going to be playing that game on the Xbox channel. Prime Gaming.
Okay, right now I'm honored to be joined by Johanna Ferris, the new GM of Call of Duty. Johanna, it's so great to have you with us here
yes!
on Kickoff Live. Everyone is so excited about what Call
Queen!
Of Duty's been doing with all these seasons. And I know, looks like next week, June 17th, season 4.
Yes, we're super excited. We're super honored.
She looks badass.
Look,
I love her outfit.
It's just such an amazing time for Call of Duty. We're experiencing such transformational growth and dynamism across the entire brand, you know, from premium title releases to everything we'll talk about today, with Warzone, with mobile, with esports. So it's just super incredible, all the work. And shout out to everybody in the Call of Duty family who makes it happen every day.
Yeah, no, you've been, I mean, I know season 3, it was like, you know, Rambo, Die Hard. Now, who knows what's in store for season 4, but you guys, you know, continually update the game now with new stuff. Season
Have
4
you
is
heard about
next
Prime?
Week. You, this is first info on it, so what
Oh,
can you
dang,
tell
our Prime,
around the world?
Our
yeah,
Prime is broken.
It's jam-packed with new content across Cold War and Warzone. You know, you've got new weapons. We've
I
got
love
new
her
maps.
Boots.
We've got badass new operators. I'm super excited about the hijacked gulag. We've got expanded zombies content for everybody who loves that part of, you know, the gameplay experience. So we're thrilled, and I'm excited to bring it forward a little bit here today.
I know. We've got the first look world premiere trailer of season 4, so let's take a look at that now.
World premiere. Take a drink.
Do what you are told, and you get to live.
Dang, that guy is sweaty.
I knew you were a smart one.
Secure the site.
Guns. Combat. Guns. Explosions. Wrestling moves. Guns. Guns, 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 guns. A hijacking. More guns.
Satellite.
Listen, I tried Warzone. I'm very bad at it. It's very complex. Oh my gosh, there's a dragon! There's a dragon! No, drink water. Drink water. Drink.
Oh my god, that looks so fun. And 1 week away.
1 week away.
All right, well, let's move on to... You first joined Activision to run Call of Duty Esports, and we're going to talk a little bit now about what is the World
Zombies
Series
Uncaged.
Of Warzone, which is going to start on June the 22nd. First of all, tell us, what is World Series of Warzone?
Yeah, we're super excited about it. It's really a new way for us to highlight competitive Call of Duty. You know, we've got great success going with Call of Duty League, and now we've got some of the biggest names in gaming battling it out in Verdansk for what will be the biggest prize pool in Warzone. Since it's launched, right? So we'll talk a little bit about what that entails, but custom lobby experiences, 150 player to a side squad. So I'm stoked to see how they kind of rally here in Verdansk.
Yes, and coming up very soon, June 22nd, looks like Twitch Rivals is gonna be a part of this?
Yeah, we are honored to be in partnership with Twitch, always, right? But certainly here with World Series of Warzone and partnering with Twitch Rivals, who's already done so much to really put competitive Warzone on display. So couldn't be in better partnership there, and we're excited to have everybody tune in.
Yes, there is one thing though that everyone has been talking about online, and that's who the captains are going to be for the structure of the World Series Warzone, at least for the first event.
Yeah.
I understand we've getting a little bit reveal here of who some of the captains are, right?
Yeah, we love the first five captains of the first of many events to come. Like I said, these are huge influencers and personalities in Call of Duty, and they also share our passion for competitive Call of Duty, right? They really believe in the promise of World Series of Warzone and to really level up what it means to really battle it out. So Couldn't be happier with some of these names, many of whom also hail from the Call of Duty League family. And I'm excited to see who kind of takes the cake here. We'll see.
I was going to say, they're all be battling out in just a couple weeks on Twitch Rivals. Well, it's really exciting to see how much Call of Duty is growing into this kind of year-round experience for everyone with so much more content. So we can't wait to see where you're going to take it. And I know there is a big new mainline game coming later this year too, right?
Indeed, indeed. More details to share later on, but Sledgehammer Games is, you know, going to bring forward something truly incredible. So we're excited.
All right. We tried, guys. There will come a time and a place for that. All right, Johanna, thank you so much for joining us.
We
appreciate it. All right, we've got lots of Summer Game Fest kickoff to go. But
right World
now,
Series
we've got
of
a
Warzone.
Surprise guest
I don't know
joining
about
us,
it, man.
My fellow Canadian, Ryan Reynolds. Hey, Ryan.
Well, thank you, Geoff. And hello, Summer Game Fest. Now, I know what you're thinking. And no, I'm not here to announce I'm the star of Elden Ring. I think. Instead, no, I'm here to talk about good old-fashioned movies. You remember those things? Of course you don't. Look, I have a new movie coming out August 13th called Free Guy, and in this movie I play an NPC character in a popular open-world video game until I break free and I realize that it kind of sucks to be a, you know, lonely background character on an endless walk cycle. So now here's one of those
Oh, yeah, he's an NPC.
Our cast on the big screen this August, and honestly, it's been so long I can't even remember who's even in this movie. I didn't say that. I'll cut that out. Yeah, I'll do it right now.
My name is Guy. I thought I had everything I needed.
Oh-ho! Mondays, am I right, Joe?
You said it, Guy.
But then I met her.
Put these on.
Oh my God!
Oh my God, why is the lawn guy over here?
Or something?
Guy, there is no easy way to say this. This world, it's a video game.
HyperX, sponsored of the movie.
And the guy responsible for this world is going to destroy it.
Are we talking about God? You've met God?
Yes, he's an absolute troll.
Trolls exist.
We can save our world, but we have to fight together.
I don't even know what's happening right now, but I love it!
That actually hurt my hand.
I have three words for you. Blue shirt guy.
This guy is outskilling all these players.
I've never seen anything like this.
Why is he so funny?
He's also really cute.
The game wasn't even made for someone like this.
Terminate him.
Nope.
It's me. That's a... identify. I'm in this movie. Yeah, I'm in this movie. I'm in the very back.
All those guys who will be in Free Guy.
I painted the wall.
I can't say it yet. All right.
I was on set.
Won multiple awards at the Game Awards. And
I passed that water.
Just keeps going. Now it's time to hear from Inner Sloth on what's coming
next. I gave people gum in the bathroom. World premiere. Oh, God. Toilet. Well, they are adding Sheriff. Oh, they must have pulled from like the mod peeps. There's achievements? Oh no. Leo, there's achievements!
Lots of fun ahead. And speaking of Among Us, last year you may remember the very rare Geoff Keighley mask was available as a Twitch drop around the Game Awards, never to be seen again. In fact, I often hear on Twitter from people who get booted from games with the mask because folks...
Oh my God, well, time to sweat!
Never fear, today
time
the mask
to get achievement.
Just head to Twitch, connect your account, and watch
15 oh, you gotta come play!
To get your very own...
We have
Geoff
a cool,
mask
awesome group.
Once again, and then it goes back into the vault. I don't know what's going on. All right. Speaking of independent developers, now I'm
it's
very
a Twitch
happy to
drop.
Welcome to Summer Game
Shoot.
Fest, the head of indies at PlayStation.
I mean, I have to watch
a legend
it on
in
Twitch.
His own right, who has some exciting things to share? Shuhei Yoshida.
What is it?
Hi, Shu.
Thanks, Geoff. Hi, everyone. I'm Shuhei Yoshida, head of PlayStation.
What is it? A war?
love about working with independent developers are the new and unexpected games that they create, which allows
the game awards. Okay.
Array of unique the drop? Experiences for players. In my role at Sony, it's very exciting to get to meet with these talented studios, which sometimes can be one person.
Oh God, it's the Twitch chat. It's very bad.
To help nurture their ideas and bring them to the PlayStation fans. One example is from Finji, who has been working with Greg Lobanov, the developer of Wondersong, to publish their new game, Chicory, A Colorful Tale. Chicory released today and gives players the chance to experience a coloring book-style world where players use their painting powers to explore, solve puzzles, make friends, and draw on anything. Check out Chicory, A Colorful Tale on PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 after the show. As a huge Soulsborne games fan, I totally enjoyed the beautiful action-adventure Salt and Sanctuary a few years ago. The developer Ska Studios has been hard at work on a new title, which I'm proud to present to you, Salt and Sacrifice.
Our sins will catch up with us.
Drop. I don't think there are drops here.
Always. I was given a second chance. I spoke the words.
I guess we can watch it on this.
I drank the mage bane.
Just don't like the overlay. Oh, here we go. How do I hide chat?
I am a marked inquisitor. There aren't many of us.
But together, we will tame the chaos.
Thanks, Shu, and that's not all. Today, we're also able to share with you a brand new trailer from the upcoming Annapurna and Heart Machine game, Solar Ash, which is coming to PlayStation later this year.
Twitch chat was a mistake. Okay. One guy. We have to try it. How's the volume? I just switched this. Gosh dang it. PlayStation. Oh God, I'm gonna fall off. Wow. I'm gonna fall off, it's gonna happen. Bonk. Bonk. So many times. With the dragon. Solar Ash. Oh, this year. Oh, PlayStation only.
That looks so, so great. Can't wait to see it later this year. Now, This week, there is a ton of video game news, but there's also a big game launching across console and PC, Chivalry 2, which brings 64-player multiplayer medieval battles to life.
Didn't we play that this week?
Swords, axes, you name it, and it comes from Torn Banner Studios in my hometown of Toronto, Canada. Here's a look at the launch trailer for Chivalry 2, which you can play right now.
Yeah, on Game Pass. Maybe. I think.
For every warrior, there comes a time when a moment.
This game is so fun.
Your fate.
It's kooky, but it's like so fun.
As the throng of battle echoes. Steel and shield, and we cry out toward eternity.
Oh,
Chivalry!
Chivalry! Let me come chop your arms off.
This month, Valorant from Riot celebrated its one-year anniversary, and starting next Monday, June 14th...
I haven't played Valorant yet. I just haven't had a chance.
...card to celebrate the one-year anniversary, and a pity party spray through June 25th. This is all leading up to the release of Episode 3 of the game later this month, which will be celebrated with an epic WW Fest Unlocked Year 1 stream on June 25th. But there will also be a new agent. Who could it be? Well, here's your first... very, very exclusive, but very, very quick tease to whet your appetite.
Watch for 15 minutes.
With more to be revealed later.
And then claim
month,
the reward, Geoff mask. During today, so if you guys are on the channel, you can claim it. So if you're watching it on their channel, you can get this Geoff mask.
I told you it was very, very quick.
Hello, Geoff. Right. It's me, Geoff.
DMC factions face off against each other in Escape from Tarkov, the popular multiplayer first-person shooter video game developed by Battlestate Games. Today, we've got an exclusive new look at the streets of Tarkov, the new area of the game under development.
Well, Premier, take a drink. Want to connect it. Wait, what is this? Tarkov? Escape from Tarkov? I played it once. Oh my god, there are people. But it ran so poorly, so maybe that's optimized a little better. You have to really hate yourself to play it. I feel that.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Bro. Trying to be like Rainbow Six. It looks like Rainbow Six. Escape from Tarkov. So much more. Get ready to escape in a world.
As a kid, the simulation games of Peter Molyneux were some of my favorites. Adding that extra salt on the fries in the theme park to increase your drink sales was so devilish. Well, many of the team members behind those sim games went on to create 2 Point Studios and 2 Point Hospital. Well, today we're excited to share the first trailer for their next 2 Point simulation, 2 Point Campus.
That first sight of the school gates, the scent of a leather-bound book, the faint clatter of knights jousting. Well, I can't say I remember that part, though it wasn't like this in my day. You see, campuses are forever changing. Nowadays, education has to be fun. It can't be all work and no play.
What is this?
Quite right, too. Apparently, the results speak for themselves. Academia has never
been party school.
More dynamic. More whatever this is. Today's campus is a place to live and a place to learn.
Why do these guys look familiar?
The sharpest minds that money can buy. Though sometimes you still can't.
2 points. That's what it is. Ho ho. 2 point. That's right.
Yes, these days it really does feel as though.
I like 2 point hospital. 2 point university. I want pizza now! Maui had to get pizza today. I'll make the rules. But college.
Point campus.
Campus.
Class is in session 2022.
If you like the sim type of games like that, you will love it.
This year, I am thrilled to have Netflix as a part of Summer Game
Fest. Let's order some pizza!
They've been doing an incredible job adapting games with series like Castlevania and the Dota anime. Well, there is a lot more coming, and you don't have to wait long to find out more. Tomorrow, I'm honored to be guest hosting Netflix's Geeked Week live stream with Mari Takahashi and Rahul Kohli. You can expect the first clip of the Cuphead show, which, spoiler alert, this show is going to be an absolute sensation. I can't wait.
I haven't played Cuphead.
We'll sit down with the team behind Arcane, the League of Legends animated show.
I haven't played it
this year, and we might also have updates on The Witcher and the live action Resident Evil series. Geeked Week is streaming live tomorrow at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern.
That's right, tomorrow.
Here's a sneak peek.
Co-op, dude, Asian, I'm down.
What is Geek?
We're playing games together.
Netflix Geek is hosting a free virtual event full of big news, exciting first looks, and the people who make the shows and films you love on Netflix. Comics, games, movies, zombies, animation, sci-fi, fantasy.
Arcane, Cuphead, Army of Affair, No Rock High, Castlevania, Stranger Things, The Witcher, and much more.
The Witcher.
From the shows you love, live.
I would like to make a gaming talk show on Netflix, please.
There's so much to get.
Dear Netflix, I heard you needed a leading lady. I'm here to help host and create an awesome gaming talk show for your Netflix series.
They continue to do some pretty amazing IP crossovers. You may remember last summer we announced the Avatar: The Last Bender one.
Hello?
Well, as Smite enters its ninth year, it's time to go upside down.
I'll be honest, I didn't watch this after the first season. Because it's creepy! Is it like survival game, maybe? Or is it a story game? Let me present The Grind, your video game talk show. Mav and Asian take the internet. Oh, and Smite. Nice. Joe, high res. Creepy. Yes, Rochelle. Bum bum bum. Dum 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 dum.
Next up, we announce a lot of games on my shows, but I think this is the first time we are announcing an entirely new game label, new game publisher. Enjoy this first look at more than 12 games that make up its initial slate.
Sometimes I ask myself what it all means.
Let's begin.
Let us begin. No, I don't want to stand. Watch. I want me to stand. Go. Do it. Doesn't Apple know how busy I am?
Is that who you are?
My purpose makes me who I am.
What? Are they like robots?
I finally have the feeling
or AI?
Something worthwhile.
Being relied on to succeed where others would fail.
Wait, I'm so confused. Oh, never mind. Wait, what? Oh, okay. What? World premiere!
Prime Matter, Payday 3-2, and there is actually one more game.
Oh, I've never played Payday.
For that, we go to Todd Hollinshead from Saber. Todd, how you doing?
I'm great, Geoff. Thank you for the intro there. I'm really excited to.
Hi, Todd.
Last edition, which is that Saber and Prime Matter are working together on a new game in the Painkiller franchise.
I've never played Payday. Right?
All right,
no, I haven't.
Cool on that, and there are more details on Prime Matter coming tomorrow with a stream at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, and I will be stopping by. Next up is a brand new IP from a brand new studio, Stray Bombay. It's coming this fall only to Xbox, PC, and Game Pass.
Rob
on some day
bank.
One. It's called The Anacrusis, a four-player cooperative first-person shooter set aboard a massive starship stranded at the edge of explored space. You team up with your friends in an infinitely replayable fight against alien hordes to unlock perks, weapons, and new ways to play that you can share with your team. Here is the world premiere trailer.
World premiere, take a drink.
Hello?
No? We're in space?
NASA! Liu! Stick together and let's do this.
Is this a disco?
This I do not like.
Oh my god. What? Hello.
This is not good. Not good.
What if we open the doors and run? Just run. No stopping, no shooting, just straight to the bridge.
Get that blaster!
It's like zombies, but Left 4 Dead, but like in space, but they're humanoid.
Heavy.
Really? We call them tanks.
I call them brutes. From Latin, Brutus.
We'd sound smart calling them brutes.
Gion, you don't want to get in here and help name these?
Nah, I'm good.
I like the style, though. Oh my gosh! I like the style.
Awesome look. Thanks for that, Chet, and the team at Stray Bombay.
Tomorrow,
tune in to Summer Game Fest.
Formal, there's
for
a new Dino game
presentation on New World, a new open world MMO from Amazon Games set on the supernatural island of Aeternum. It's finally coming out later this summer, and in the deep dive,
you missed
video,
the dinos. Geoff Goldblum announced the dino game.
Supernatural island that is a world of wonder and horror. Once you arrive, it's up to you to unite warring human factions to take on a common enemy, the Tempest.
Formal's probably so sick of dinosaurs because of Ark.
Will detail updates to the game.
Oh, guess what? I'm talking to someone from Ark on Friday.
Expeditions, five-player challenges with unique mechanics, bosses, loot, and more.
Whoa.
Six of these expeditions will be at launch with the closed beta on July 20th and the public launch on August 31st.
This looks cool.
I will also be down at the studio.
New World.
Team's efforts over the past year in the midst of COVID. It is exciting for me to finally be able to get out there and visit game studios again. I miss all these developers. So check out the special deep dive stream on New World tomorrow at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern at summergamefest.com. All right, well, back in 2018,
Rocket League
teamed up with Fast and Furious, bringing some of the saga's most iconic
Into
the game. And now they are back with a twist that is truly Rocket League, with Fast 9, the next installment of the Fast saga, arriving in U.S. theaters June 25th. Psyonix is bringing back the Nissan Skyline, Dodge Charger, and, well, maybe the most literal, supersonic, acrobatic, rocket-powered heist car ever conceived, the F9 Pontiac Fiero.
Pontiac. Whoa. The Charger. Meow. Look at that body kit. Wait. What is this? Rocket League. Fast and Furious. Oh my gosh. Okay, I was like, that's Rocket League.
Strap a rocket engine to a car and play soccer.
Oh no, Asian.
Seems like the right idea to me. The Fast and Furious three-car bundle arrives June 17th in Rocket League. Okay, next up, last year, a new Swedish company named Shark Mob released a teaser for their first unnamed multiplayer project in the Vampire the Masquerade universe. Tonight, we're putting a name on their first game with a brand new
Look at this art.
Trailer.
Look at this. The stage is so cool. World premiere, take a drink. Alpha footage. Okay, here we go.
Centuries we have lived in secrecy among you, maintaining
I'm in
masquerade.
I'm so in.
We have
Edward
your society, fed on your blood.
Oh, he's dead.
Thrived among you.
Oh, he's gone.
Until now.
Oh no. Are we hunting them? Oh, yes. He's dead. Blood hunt. Hello? I need to be a vampire. Let's see.
I can't wait to play this game, and we actually won't have to wait long. You can sign up now. For the bloodhunt.com is where you go for the closed alpha PC test available on July 2nd. Bloodhunt will be released later this year. Next, the latest horror game series from the creators of Until Dawn continues with the House of
Ashes. I'm so down. That looks so fun.
This third game features American and Iraqi soldiers stranded in a cursed temple. Here's the story trailer with the exclusive reveal of the monsters lurking in the depths.
An ancient horror has awoken from its slumber and is hungry for blood. Shall we see how many have fallen into shadow?
Satellite sweeps of the war zone have uncovered what appears to be an underground storage facility. But I strongly suspect it's where chemical weapons are hidden, so we need to move fast.
Ready to go, guard.
To descend into the unknown alone is extremely brave.
Men out, hold fire.
Or extremely foolish.
We're gonna sigh out this shit.
Brothers in arms, or will it be a case of each man for himself?
Down, get down! They're up on the ridge! Return fire!
You teeter on the edge of an abyss.
Oh, shit.
Your survival depends on the choices you make. They will be as a compass, guiding you through the unknown.
Where on God's green earth have we landed?
What nightmare have these luckless souls fallen into?
You keep lookout.
Lookout? Lookout for what?
One by one, their lights will be snuffed out. Unless you can find the means to save them. Trapped beneath the earth. Swallowed.
We have to move. Let's go.
By the void. Will you find the path to salvation? Or be lost in the darkness? Forever.
The Twilight Zone. Formal, I'm in! Is this single player? Spooky!
One of the longest, most beloved JRPG franchises in the industry is the Tales of series. Well, the latest game, Arise, was announced 2 years ago, and it
Tales
brings
of
the franchise
what?
Into stunning 3D with Unreal
This is not
Engine
a first
4.
Installment?
Here's a world premiere look at the latest trailer, with more information following in the coming weeks.
World premiere. Ooh.
Pretty fancy place they got here.
Harmony and coexistence between the Renans and the Danans.
I'm Dohilim Ilkaris. Should you need my
you
skills
make it co-op?
On the battlefield, all I care for is maintaining peace.
I'm Captain Kisara of the Elder Menencia Guard.
I just spit my spit out.
From now on, when I fight to
no!
protect my dream.
Well, this crew just gets bigger and bigger.
The Renans. Seems the rumors you were running with them were true.
Radiant blood, get toasty!
Burn strike!
Been looking for you.
Olaf, get the hell out of my realm! This is Tannin's realm!
Oh, the little hope
series.
Have we played Little Hope?
Is it over?
It's only just begun.
For Summer Game Fest, we have a special announcement for you. That the console version of Sky Children of the Light would arrive to Nintendo Switch on June 29th. And the Little Prince season would start soon after on July 6th.
Aww. It's so
Enjoy
pretty! It's two player. Oh, Le Petit Prince.
One of the things I take great pleasure in is using a platform like this show to introduce you to new developers and studios with games that deserve the spotlight. That's definitely the case with this
what
next
shoes
title.
Are he wearing? What shoes are he wearing? Are he wearing?
Planet
I can't speak English.
Planet tells the story of a young girl and her loyal friend who embark on a mission through a colorful world.
What shoes are he?
Like a gouache watercolor
is he? Is he?
What
Here's shoes
your first
is he wearing?
At the Planet of Lana.
Wait, how do I say
Xbox
it?
Xbox PC in 2022.
Bye. Have a great one. The Little Prince a game? Wait, is it not a game? What is this? Meow. It's a cat. This is pretty. I like that there are no UIs. Hi, Ash. They're books? The Little Prince? Oh, I want to write that down. I don't want to forget. Oh no! No, no! We are playing this. We are playing this. Hand painted. Oh no, it's a platformer. Never mind. Planet of Lana. This is so cute. The next year is going to be awesome. The Traveler! I need a screenshot. It's so pretty. Maybe that's why I like it. I don't know. This thing's so pretty. I haven't played Ori, actually. Maybe we should. Honor to have that. Oh my gosh. Well,
joining me now,
there are so many games. Overwatch 2!
Overwatch 2, Aaron. Great to have you here on Kickoff Live.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you so much.
Please be different.
Yeah, we are. Please be different. To please learn be different. Please be different. What's planned for Overwatch 2? You guys recently, you had a PvP live stream that I watched, and you revealed some changes coming to Overwatch 2. What can you tell us? What's the latest?
Wait, is it the current Overwatch or is it new?
That Overwatch 2's format is changing to a 5v5 team format. This requires a fresh look at all of our heroes in the game. It should feel new yet familiar to fans of our strategic team-based combat.
Yeah, it was great to see you guys playing and, you know,
separate game. It's a new game
for people to get a chance to go hands on with it. And today I know you brought us a look at some skins for some of the characters, right?
Yeah, the team is so passionate about updating the look and the 5v5. Feel of the world of Overwatch.
Yeah, 5v5.
And one aspect
we could
of
totally
that
do
is
a 5v5.
Entirely new models for Overwatch 2 for all of our heroes. So today we're going to be
I know they
at
showed
of those,
more of it
Baptiste
earlier.
And Sombra.
All right, well, let's take a look here, and I know you're going to tell us a little bit about what we're seeing, but it's so cool.
Okay, let's look.
Brought into Overwatch 2, so yeah, what do we got here?
Yeah, so this is Baptiste, and there's a lot of new technology that go into our models. We have new hair shader tech, excuse me, in order to get the look that we're going for.
Share hater,
aw,
I've done that.
A glowing cape and gloves that kind of give that medic or surgeon vibe to him.
Oh no.
Thank you.
And now we're going to Sombra, I think, right?
Yep, so next up is Sombra. This was a very challenging look for us to update. It's an asymmetrical
She's
design.
She's so pretty!
There's so many layers of hair and clothing and technology in this. If you look closely, you can actually see circuitry and nodes embedded in her clothing. She is a world-class hacker, so it all makes sense.
No, again, it's, you know, so great for fans to see these characters you know and love. The first game.
She's a mom too. Let's go. We simp.
Can't wait to see more on the game.
Yes.
A little sneak preview here.
A share hater. Yeah. Same.
On Overwatch 2.
You bet. Thank you.
Awesome. All right. Thanks very much.
Genji.
Now, recently, I had a chance to play Dungeons and Dragons: Dark Alliance with the game developer Geoff Haddam, Hannibal Buress, and Ember Moon from the WWE. That's right. You didn't expect me to say that. But this game is a ton of fun, and it's coming to Game Pass on June 22nd. Take a look. Hey guys, it's Geoff Keighley, and today, as part of Summer Game Fest, we are going hands-on with a game that is coming out in just a couple of weeks. It is Dark Alliance, and we've got Geoff, one of the game developers.
Ooh!
Hey, Geoff. Special guests, Hannibal Buress and Ember Moon.
Okay, okay. That looks like a trap.
Oh, spice.
That looks like a trap.
Oh, my God. Traps.
Ow. Oh, sh.
Oh no, you get oh, no.
A warrior's death. I died again.
I'm coming to get you.
Hey, hey,
oh.
Hey.
Watch it.
Oh.
Oh no. Oh no, I can't believe I'm down. I'm down.
I'm just looking at the UI.
Dev is down.
A D&D game.
Really,
that's kind of cool.
Absolutely. I've read all the books, especially the Driss backstory. I just connected with it on such an intimate level to the point
they have the elf on here.
Character that everyone sees on TV is actually based on this character. The red eyes, even though Driss has purple, I just love everything about him, that he's just constantly the good guy the entire time.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh, what the?
Oh.
He's a Verbeek chef.
That doesn't look healthy at all.
Chat, I hope you're hungry.
I'm here now.
Whoa.
I spoke way too soon.
We got him. We got him.
Come on.
He's gone.
Come on.
He's gone.
Come on.
We don't want any dessert.
There you go.
Let's go.
Damn. What a death. I'm going to have some weird dreams tonight because of that. Oh, he flipped us up.
Act complete.
That was great.
Yeah.
Get it.
The
Game Pass 2, I'm gonna try it. Yes. People still play Paladins for sure. But I wonder what their gen lock.
All right, Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live presented by Prime Gaming continues. Yesterday was an amazing tease of the next Battlefield from EA. And if you want to dust up on the history of the franchise, its last big modern day game, that was Battlefield 4. It's this month. Prime Gaming members get to download it and play it for free through June 20th. Now, there's no catch. This is the full-blown PC version of the 2013 game, and those only in Battlefield moments still hold up. Just head to gaming.amazon.com to redeem your free copy right now if you are an Amazon Prime member. And this Sunday, watch the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase for the first gameplay footage of Battlefield 2042. Gonna be really cool. All right, right now, let's take a look at another world premiere. Monster Hunter Stories is coming to the Switch.
I'm so excited for this.
We've got your first look at the story trailer.
Oh, my Switch. I love my Switch.
Wings of
Can I play the second one without the first one, I think? I wonder. I haven't played Control. I have it. It is literally top 10 of games I want to make sure I play this year, actually. I heard it's really good. Monster Hunter Stories? Yes. Many hours of Monster Hunter in this house. It's free on Epic? Oh, let me double check then.
That's the monster.
I know they sent me a code.
Suppose he saw this coming?
We won't let you awaken it.
So, you're going to be born, huh?
I love it. It looks Kimura. It's so cute. Wait, what? We get our Monster Hunter Rise characters
Next,
can be transferred?
Rock band hits the road this summer
to
on the
story?
Hella Mega Tour with Green Day and Fall Out Boy. But first, they came together with an indie developer to create stream-safe music for the community. Yes, you can co-stream this performance. So turn it up. Premiering their brand new, never-before-released song, Tell Me What You Want, from Wavebreak, this is Weezer!
Wavebreak. Dang, look at his mane. No, it's not DMCA. Weezer announced that it's not. It's stream safe. Yeah, this song actually, I don't know about their older stuff, but this song is stream safe. DMCA? There might be, there actually probably is music with the showcase that is DMCA hittable, so I will be deleting the VOD, but I'm recording right now, so that way I'll just put it up on YouTube, and if you guys want to watch it or miss this part, I will put it up there right after stream. Right? It's a big chance, yeah, you got the next 3 seconds. Tell me what you want. Remember when they were young? They're so timeless, though. Tell me what you want. Hold on, let me see here. With animals and boats? I think so. It looks so cute. Exclusively on PC and Xbox, Planet of Lana. I wonder if I'll get to pre-play it.
Thank you, Rivers and guys, for that. Both the song and the game released tomorrow on PC, Nintendo Switch,
tomorrow!
Music streaming platforms, Twitch soundtrack, and a limited edition 7-inch vinyl on IM8-bit. All right, well, right now, let's turn to a game that we announced last year at the Game Awards, Endless Dungeon from Amplitude. We showed a brief glimpse of gameplay in December, and fans wanted more. Well, here's an extended look at Endless Dungeon.
Endless Dungeon world premiere. Take a drink. Drink your water.
We're stuck in this wreck.
Sega.
Until everybody learns the rules. Yep, all of them. Rule number one: certain weapons work better on certain monsters. Learn it or die. Oh, option B then. Rule number two: use turrets to protect that unstable dust bomb we call the crystal.
Shoot on my hamsters.
And if it goes,
let me add.
You go. Yep, just like that. Rule number three: watch your squad. Even if you've got the guns, the turrets, and the crystal, you can't do everything by yourself. If you fight alone, you die alone. Together again. And rule number four? Well, if you've got all that going, but you still can't win, you gotta change the squad. Tag team. I'm in.
What are you guys doing tonight? If you're lucky enough to have a PS5, you're probably getting ready to play Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. I've been playing it and having a ton of fun. Well, later today, the team at Insomniac is going to be doing a special launch stream on Twitch. And to tell us more, take it away, Marcus and Mike.
Hey, Geoff, and everybody watching Summer Games Fest Kickoff Live. Marcus Smith here, creative director at Insomniac Games for Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart. We're excited that players finally get a chance to play the game tomorrow, and to celebrate, we want to spend some more time with you today. At 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern.
Tonight. Yeah, that's awesome. That's so cool. I hope we see more of that, but I don't know.
I'm Mike Daly, the game director of Rift Apart.
In addition to playing through the opening of the game, we'll also be taking your questions live and talking about what it was like to develop the game behind the scenes. So please join us at twitch.tv/insomniacgames at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern.
We'll see you there.
All right, we're now about to be joined by the one and only Giancarlo Esposito to talk Far Cry 6. Giancarlo, thank you for joining us. So why did you want to take on this role?
They came to me with this phenomenal idea and had proposed that I play Anton Castillo, the leader of Yara, with this big vision and dream for his country. And it really appealed to me because he was a guy who first came from a love of his family and a love of his community and country. And it was so in line with what's going on in the world politically today and what has happened
in the
past.
Such an awesome set.
What a great
opportunity. I can't get over the stage.
The other part of it is it's just a different technology that's so brand new. It
excites
me as a filmmaker that I want to be a part of it.
All right, well, you've played some absolutely amazing villains in your career. What was it like being a video game villain?
No, I'm not a villain. I gotta push back on you. I'll let you finish. But this guy loves his country.
Far Cry 6.
He wants to empower you, Keighley. He wants to empower you to stand up and speak your truth. Now you can go back to calling me a villain if you like.
Well, you are smiling on the box. You're a good guy, right?
I am, because I feel like we as human beings fall in line. And I want to be a renegade within reason. How do you like that? Because I think part and parcel of us falling in line and doing what we need to do and thinking about the cumulative effect of our doing what's right and the example of that is also to stand up and say, no, I do agree that they're good and bad about all people, but this guy, out of his love and passion for his people, even if they're faceless to him at certain points in time, allow him to be an absolute hero.
Speaking of your character, who did you base him on or study to create this character?
It's so interesting because, of course, the obvious choice to study is Fidel Castro, and it is Cuba, an island that had so many resources, but really the dream of the ability of the dictator to cultivate those resources, something got in the way there. And hopefully that can change in the years to come. Funny you asked me that question, because I was just talking to one of my daughters about Ceausescu and also Hitler, because we were talking about zodiac signs and what signs were certain people. What is that mindset that has you wanting to have power over others? And for each dictator, it's different. She'd never heard of Ceausescu and studied political science and all this in college. Where'd my money go? So anyway.
All right, well, one last question for you. Who would win in a square off between Gus Fring, Moff Gideon, and Anton?
Oh, my God.
You know, and I have my favorites in those, too. So you asked me this question. And you know, immediately I say Moff Gideon. Immediately. You know, somehow I think Gus is colder and displays that coldness in a very particular way. You know, I think Anton could be the most violent man on earth, but given his situation, he may not rise to that occasion or may not have the time. Moff Gideon is otherworldly. This guy thinks in a different way, and he knows what you're thinking before you say it. And he does all his own.
How cool to be able to play
and
these characters, man. That's so awesome.
So I'm going to say Moff Gideon.
Fair enough. All right, Giancarlo, thank you so much for hanging out with us. We will check out the revolution in Far Cry 6.
And I can't wait for it to begin. Let the games begin!
Awesome. All right, thank you so much, Giancarlo. If you haven't picked up on it yet, Prime Gaming unlocks a ton of in-game benefits for Amazon Prime members, like an exclusive Valkyrie skin in Apex Legends, $200,000 in GTA cash every week you play GTA Online, and in Fall Guys, you get a special Burning Circuits costume for your bean through June 21st. Now, speaking of Fall Guys, the time has come to reveal a brand new costume coming to the game based on a legendary game franchise. Check it out.
What? Oh, it's B2! B2, right? I haven't played it, but... I was there to help Data with his boobs. That's awesome. That's awesome. It's so cute. Genshin! Paimon! Double D Dado. He actually stopped by last night. Straight up Dado costume, right?
Organizing the clash is my way of uncovering hidden talents.
Right.
And hopefully this time, getting a vision to glow again. Your opponent is new to the clash, but he has quickly become the dark horse of the tournament. The vision is missing.
The sounds of nature turn into a clamor of noise during stormy weather. The winds are coming. Clouds hide. The birds come!
Genshin Impact. I forgot the impact
so
was even the word.
So today we've games, a publisher, Prime Matter, so why not announce a developer too? And joining me now are Dave Anthony and Jason Blundell from the newly formed Deviation Games. We know you guys well from all your amazing work over the years at Treyarch and Call of Duty Black Ops, but what can we expect from your new studio, guys?
Well, thanks, Geoff. And look, Jason and I, we've been mates for donkey's years. And well, like an old married couple, Geoff, and we've been working together for decades. And we've worked on some huge franchises. You know the games, you know, they've done well. And but we thought, you know, when you're working on those franchises, the long established IPs, you're working within very, very tight constraints creatively about what you can do. So we thought, after all these years, you know, what if we deviated?
Yes.
So that's Deviation Games.
Okay.
So Geoff, just trust me, all bets are off. From
right.
day one, we got complete financial security to work with creative freedom and time, not just to make a brand new IP, which is what we're doing, but a groundbreaking new IP with innovation at its very core. And the team at Deviation Games, the culture we have is really, really simple. It's, there's no place for ego. It's the best idea that always wins, and that's Deviation Games.
All right, well, big ideas from you guys as we would expect. Now, I know it's very early and there is nothing to show on the game today, but can you tell us a bit about what kind of game you're making? What can we expect?
Yeah, I mean, you're very right there, Geoff. Very early, but a lot of exciting stuff going on. So essentially, we spent the last year building the team, right? And so what we knew was we wanted to collect passionate, creative, collaborative people and bring them together kind of under one roof, and that's what Deviation Games is. So yeah, we don't have anything to show right now, but that collaboration, that imagination is going on, and we're going to have something that's going to, I think, leave an indelible mark in the industry when we come out.
All right. Well, with you guys involved, as I said, we're excited about it. There is one more piece of the puzzle, though, that you want to reveal today, and for that, let's take a look at this.
What they're up to. Oh, they're working with PlayStation. Whew.
Okay, big news. The stage has changed. Blue of PlayStation. So you're partnering with PlayStation. What can you tell us about that partnership?
That's right, Geoff. And
tell
the
us.
Partnership with PlayStation, it's all about quality. From soup to nuts, this project is all about quality. And our team of deviators that we have back in the studio, we're doing this for you. We are so proud of you. And the partnership
Aww,
with Sony,
he's nervous.
It's very, very simple. I mean, God, just look at the track record of consistency, of high-quality games that they do. It's hit after hit. It's award after award. And now we've been part of this process, and we see how they do things.
Yeah.
It's really clear how they're managing to accomplish that. So we couldn't be more proud to expand PlayStation's portfolio,
yeah.
which we're going to do in a very, very significant way.
I mean, let's just face it, right? Sony rocks, and they get our kind of brand of crazy, so we're
That's
very
right.
happy with this partnership.
To be.
All right, so Deviation Games, yeah. PlayStation, brand new IP, a mega IP, it sounds like, coming in the future, and hopefully we'll see you guys again in the future to see more on what you're working on.
Thanks a lot, Jeff.
Awesome. All right. Dave, Jason, thank you very much, guys. All right. Well, this year is the 30th anniversary of Sonic the Hedgehog, and later this month, we are honored to be premiering the full Sonic Symphony performance. But right
30
now,
years?
The Philharmonic Orchestra in Prague performing the music of Sonic Unleashed.
Where's Knuckles? Score to drop. Oh my god! No way! Where is that? Wait. Sorry, well, hold on. This is so funny. Good Lord. Where is it?
Love orchestra music. All right, Sunday,
I panicked.
Warner Brothers Games and Turtle Rock will be giving players a new look at the zombie multiplayer fun of Back 4 Blood. And right now, we've got a quick tease of a new boss and news on the beta coming later this summer. One of the things I'm most passionate about is getting you guys access to play more games at home. Last year, Steam and Xbox did incredible demo events around Summer Game Fest, and this year, Steam's Next Fest starts next Wednesday, and Xbox is back again to do an ID at Xbox demo event, which I'm announcing right now. It starts on Tuesday, and it's completely free, no badges required. One of the games I'm most excited about in the lineup is Tunic, by my fellow Canadian, Andrew Scholdice. Here he is to give you a little sneak preview of the brand new demo, which you can exclusively play on Xbox starting on Tuesday.
Hi, my name's Andrew Scholdice, and I'm working on Tunic, which is an isometric action-adventure about a tiny fox in a big world.
Oh, this is so cute!
And find secrets. I first started working on it about 6 years ago. It's been changing a lot over the years, but I'm really excited about where we've gotten to today. So in Tunic, you start the game and you are a little fox that's washed up on a beach, and you don't have a whole lot of context except for, you know, a lust for adventure, and you are going to wander off and maybe you're going to find a stick, and maybe if you venture a little bit further, maybe you're going to find a sword. And it's really about that sense of discovery, about wondering what's around the next corner. People have played the game at shows before, but we wanted to put together a brand new demo that was, you know, for the home audience. And so it's full of never before seen stuff, a brand new dungeon, a bunch of areas people haven't seen before.
You have to have the game, Summer Game Fest on this. You need to have this on. You have till 3 p.m. I think they're going to replay this, so you have plenty of time. Next but up, you have to play it for 15 minutes, I believe.
This ancient Norse-inspired co-op action survival RPG that you can also fully play solo. Classic hack and slash gameplay goes Viking in Norse fells.
It might work here. I'm not sure, actually.
And PC July 27th. Here is the brand new trailer.
The giants have come to Midgard, and you have been chosen by the gods to protect this realm. But your first task is to find some new clothes that aren't as drafty. Your tribe's journey starts in the wilderness. Hunt down pets, gather rare resources, and explore the untamed world. Once you've plundered all you can carry, return to your village and use those resources to forge.
What? It's almost time for what?
You must protect the seed of Yggdrasil at all costs, or this world and everything in it will be destroyed forever. So take heed. The Helthings rise when the sun sets. Destroy these dark spirits before they destroy the seed. Each victorious night makes way for a new day to venture into new lands, build to greater heights, and face fiercer creatures. And with great risk comes great rewards. But be careful. You're of little use to Midgard, squashed by a troll. Craft legendary weapons, build deadly defenses, and grow the strength of your tribe, because those giants are on their way. And it's time for us to end their path of destruction. Let's show them our might is greater than their height. As the saying goes, Valhalla.
Y'all remember Valheim? Valheim was so good though. I just wish they did more, but they literally have five devs on the game. So, man, Valheim was so fun.
Who's ready for some Evil Dead? We announced this game last December at TGA, and now it's time for an extended look at the gameplay. To tell us more, let's turn it over to my friend, Tim Willits from Saber.
Hi, Geoff. It's great to see you. Today, we have some extended footage of The Evil Dead, the game. We are excited to show you this. And to help me explain it is Bruce Campbell. Thank you.
Got an awesome office.
Hola, cyber friends. I'm Bruce Campbell. You know me as Ash Williams, the dude who saved the world from evil. I'm here to bring you the lowdown on the upcoming Evil Dead, the game.
Wait, what is this based off of?
You and your friends will team up as classic Evil Dead heroes to live the nightmare.
Oh, it's a show?
Savage finishing moves.
Is it a show?
Evil a new one. Or, if you're not into the whole save the world thing, we have another option.
This looks like Friday the 13th.
You can play as the vile Kandarian demon itself.
The movie?
But who would want to do that? He'd be a dick.
Ash and the
With
Evil
the power
Dead.
Of possession in your arsenal.
Oh, it's a movie.
Scare those goody two shoes to death.
I don't think I've seen
Literally,
it. Have I seen
you
it?
Can do that if you're a dick. Whether you choose the path of evil or righteousness, you'll be throwing down in places you've seen before. You'll collect pages of the Necronomicon, uncover Nobi's lost tapes, and track down other legendary artifacts. When you've grabbed enough, you'll use a spell to send the Kandarian
chat knows way more about things I don't remember. This is Friday the 13th all over again. It looks like Friday the 13th.
But for now,
I'm not mad about it. I'm not mad about it.
Ash always wore brown pants.
Except Friday the 13th is like some weird guy creeping on people. This is like knight in shining armor and zombies and
okay, guys.
A dude with a mullet and chainsaws.
This is extremely special. Today, I am so deeply honored to be given the opportunity to share this next game.
Elden Ring.
It comes from one of our industry's most acclaimed developers.
Elden Ring.
And a previous Game of the Year winner at the Game Awards.
Wait, what?
I want to personally thank this developer for believing in my vision of Summer Game Fest as a new way to bring all of us together for a cross-industry showcase and kick off the summer in the right way. So, without further ado, please sit back and enjoy this truly spectacular world premiere.
World premiere, take a drink.
It is finally time.
World premiere, he's going to explode.
The Tarnished will soon return, guided by grace once lost.
Wait for it! Wait for it! This way, it's out of the ring!
To its core.
Wait! Wait, don't jinx it! Wait till you see this. Wait! Wait to see the title! Wait till you see the title. Wait for it. Oh my gosh.
Foul Tarnished. In search of the Elden Ring.
Ah, they said it! Time.
They will fight. And they will die.
For when?
In an unending curse.
You guys! GG to Geoff for getting Elden Ring launched! I just wanna know!
Elden
Ring! January! Okay, January! Oh my god!
It actually happened.
It's happening!
Elden Ring is coming, as you saw, January 21st, 2022, to next gen, current gen. It's so incredible, and I want to thank so much Miyazaki-san and the team at From for sharing that in-game look at Elden Ring. I hope you guys are happy. Oh my God, I'm free out of prison, all right. And that's gonna do it for Summer Game Fest Kickoff Live. Thank you so much to all the developers who took part, and for you and watching around the world, it means so much to me. Summer Game Fest continues all weekend with Netflix Geeked Week and Prime Matter tomorrow, Ubisoft Forward on Saturday, and Xbox and Bethesda on Sunday, Square Enix as well. Head to summergamefest.com for the full and complete schedule, and this is really just the kickoff to summer and a ton of other amazing events that I'm fully supportive of, and I'm very excited to see what they have in store for us as well. As for me, I'll see you again on August 25th for Gamescom Opening Night Live. And this December, I am so happy to say that the Game Awards will return as an in-person ceremony at the Microsoft Theater in Los Angeles. More details are coming later this summer. Thanks again for being a part of Summer Game Fest. We will see you tomorrow for more.
Can we get some hype in the chat for Geoff?
And Double Fine.
Right, Joshua!
Now. Good night, everybody.
Right, Lord of the Rings means mushrooms. It's so true. It's so true. Oh my God. Dude. It's going to be so good. I thought chat was going to throw up. All right, well, so we've got a lot of really cool things this month. Very exciting. What time is it?
Hello, and welcome to Day of the Devs, a digital showcase of the best of independent games brought to you by Double
So
Fine.
Right now, they're going to be doing, right after this Summer Games Fest, they're doing like an indie show calling it the Day of the Devs. Day of the Devs. So you guys can stick around for that. We've got the Xbox Showcase and Bethesda Showcase this Sunday. The tomorrow, what is it, Netflix Geeked stuff is coming, and super excited. Oh my God, that did not disappoint. That was an amazing game showcase. What a way to kick off the summer. Congrats to Geoff and the team. I know they've been working so hard. I'm so proud. It has come so far. Like, there wasn't even a game that I was like, I don't know. Everything was so just so nicely just shared and showcased, and the stage was cool, and it just shows that they worked so hard. So GG's, and Weezer's new song, and you can stream it. Amazing. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.